Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to MoreShay with Marshay. My name is Marshay. I'm making this video again because I'm sitting in traffic. I'm ready to go. I need to get to work, as always. But I guess where I work at must be a hotspot or something because there's always an extreme amount of traffic. Can't get there easily, and yes, that's a problem. Let me turn this radio down just in case it be in the back of my video like it was one of mine and it almost got flagged. But I came on here because I was thinking about this ever since a person made this comment, and I already feel this way about myself. So a person was making a certain comment about not wanting someone to be a black sheep of a family. And in my head, I started to think about me, of course. And I'm already, well, in my head, the black sheep of my family or families. And people may not agree with me. They may say, well, how are you the black sheep if, you know, you're close to like both sides of your family for the most part? We see you around your family. You interact with your family. You see your family. Like, you don't seem distant or separated or, but I am. That's the crazy part. The crazy part is people think that just because you're around people, they may see you in a picture, they may see you smiling, they may see you hug, they may see anything, a post, anything, and they think social media is real life. And that's why I have to always constantly remind people that Instagram is a highlight reel. It's showing the best moments of your life. It's showing the moments that you want to share, the moments that you want people to see, the things that you don't mind sharing, but it is not showing your entire life. And that's not to say I got treated horribly by my family or anything of that sort either. But I've never been the one to fit in with either sides of my family. I feel like, well, maybe it's what I feel, but I feel like with my both sides of my family, I'm not even about to point out no side. There's one side that may be a little more this way, a little more that way. And me, I'm like, I don't even want to say I'm a good mixture in between, but I have my own thoughts, opinions, and feelings on a lot of things that separates me from people in general. So I don't fit in many places. So I can't even point the finger at people and say they're intentionally pushing me out or intentionally trying to separate me or intentionally trying not to include me. I can't even say it's that. What I can say is because of who I am, because of how I think, because of how I feel, because of who I have always been for the most part, how I carry myself, like I just, even as a child, I was different. I know people use the word different. They say, we're all different, but we're all the same. That's true. We're all different, but we're all the same. You know, but me, I am literally different. I am literally nothing like the people that are around me. And I've never been. And I've always thought different. I've always felt different. Like, even when it comes to my son and being a parent, I speak about that because that's like my current life. I'm a mom now, you know? And I just feel like me, I don't, with me, I'm going to let you go, but like, I need to hurry up. But with me, I am very much, yeah, I'm going to let you go, but hurry up. But me, I am very much normally the person who, even as a child, young child, just different, right? Like, I never said the words, okay, boom, I just thought of one example. Everybody around me at a young age, I don't know what age it was, but everybody started using, you know, slang, started talking in a certain way. And everybody started calling each other Mo and saying, I'm good, and saying whatever else they would say at that young age, like Mo this, da 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 da, I'm good, da 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 da. I never in my life, I'm 28 years old now, of course, what I look like saying I'm good, but I never, even at whatever age we started using those terms, talk like I'm good or Mo, or even I just had a conversation with someone a couple of times recently, like a few conversations, and they were like, I've never heard you curse, and I've talked to you at least 3 times, and I'm like, that's because I just don't curse. Like, and in regular conversation, like, you may hear me slip out and say a curse word on YouTube because I'm expressing myself. So when I'm saying certain things, yeah, I may get hyped up, may say certain curse words, intense conversation, passionate about certain things, and may slip out or whatever. But for the most part, on an everyday basis, 24/7, having a normal conversation, you will not hear Marshay just curse out of nowhere. I gotta be extremely comfortable with you, or it gotta be something that I'm passionate about, that I'm talking about, that makes me upset or something, for me to really, really, really like curse. Because even when I'm angry, upset, mad at people, whatever. I don't just curse them out. I've never been that person. Again, when people are angry, they're upset, it's okay. They're going to express themselves in that way. They're going to curse you out. Me, I got like a polite curse out or something. It's like, I feel some type of way. I'm going to let you know about yourself. I'm going to carry you. Yeah, I do feel like I carry people and I could be a little rude, but my rudeness could come without cursing. It reminds me of one of my teachers that I had. She, of course, she didn't curse at us, but she used to have like a tone, or not even a tone, because she would say it nicely, but it was like, it was something hidden under the way that she would speak that you could feel the intense rudeness, where like a lot of people were scared to step on her toes or be a certain way around her. But she was nice in a way, because I loved her to this day. And I almost want to say her name, but I don't know where she is in life to say that. But like, she was nice. But it was like this nice nasty almost. And when I curse people out or get mad at you, it's almost that. Like, I'm not going to curse you out and say F you, da 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 da, and my F and this and that. Like, that's not the way I carry myself. That's not the way I talk, even when angry, for the most part. I can't even think of a conversation I've had with anyone like that. But there are times where I say it to myself, because people be taking me there. But I just don't believe in, like, interact like that. So from a young age, I never even talk like how people talk. Yes, I've been around those places. I've had summer jobs in DC ever since summer jobs began at 14 and stopped whenever I got like a real job. I don't know, 18 19, I might have still did it one of those summers when I was grown. But for the most part, I've never, even getting around them, being around them, I don't talk like that. I'm not going to be like, oh, whatever the terminology is, cap. I don't even use cap. I never did. Like, I'm not, somebody's talking, be like, cap. Like, that's not how I talk. That's not how I interact. I use, like, basic English for the most part. Now, there are certain words that I say, like, I don't even, y'all probably be like, that's lame. Like, all right, yeah. Anybody says, all right, right? But like, and my son, he be saying it because I talk like that, so he be like, all right, or I, right, or stuff like that. Or one word I always use was the F-U-C-K. Now, I don't just say F-U-C-K by itself, I say the F-U-C-K. But aside from that, I never really been no big cursor. I never really been no big slang user. Like, you're not gonna hear me just talking saying that's cap, or I'm go, or mo, or what's up. Like, even me speaking, saying hi, people used to say this to me like in sixth grade. They was like, why you even when I text, they like, why when you text you say thanks or thank you, why you don't put like a bunch of s's behind the things, why you don't say thank you with a bunch of u's, or laugh out loud behind every sentence. Like, my cousin, she used to say laugh out loud behind everything, even when it really wasn't funny or it had no hidden joke or innuendo. And so me, I started putting laugh out loud a little bit just to soften the way I talk, because I'm like, maybe that's the way you have to come across via text. But it's just like, that's not me. Like, I'm not that person. I've never been that person. I've always been unique. Anybody that could see me or know me, experience me, will tell you, nah, she's different for real. Like, it's not no Instagram different, it's not no social media different, it's not no I'm trying to fake for the blogs, or I am really unique. And when someone sent me a message recently reminding me to keep going, to keep doing my videos, to keep going with my show, because they're like, I see something in you, you're different, the way you handle conversation is different, the way you speak about celebrities is different. And I've always been told that, and I've been told that by a few people, is what I mean. And I've come across a couple of people who have said the same thing, like, you just different. The conversation is different. When you talk to you, how you carry yourself is different. Who you are is different. And it's not something I'm putting on a show, pretending to be. This is who I am. And I'm, at the same time, I've always loved God, like, even at a very, very young age. And so I've never been the person to, I'm gonna drink and smoke. Like, I'm sorry, like, this is the way the world is in 2023, where everybody wants to drink and smoke and go party and fall out and twerk. And I twerk behind closed doors sometimes, like, I'm not even gonna lie, like, because I used to love Big Frida, not off of no sexual stuff. I know y'all might have automatically went there like, what? Or you might have automatically thought, I don't know, she just in the room twerking. But no, I used to watch Big Frida, and I'm a big, huge Big Frida fan. So when someone introduced me to the character, I don't want to say the character, like, he's not a person. When someone introduced me to the show and they told me about who Big Frida was, and I began to watch Big Frida's show and learn about his bounce music. Bounce music was something I began to play at home and like twerk and bounce too, because it's fun. But I've never been that person to just be out going to clubs, going to bars, even at a young age when we used to have like little, I don't know if you want to call it go-go's, I think it was called go-go's or whatever. I know my uncle used to be there like all the time, every time they had one, every weekend, posed up with his friends and taking pictures and going out. I don't have a crew like that. Like, that's not me. I've never been that girl to go out with my friends and go get drunk, hang out the bar. It's never been me. I've never been the girl to go to brunch every Sunday, twerking, standing on things. I've never been that girl. And so it's hard for me because I guess people look at me and I look normal, right? I look regular, right? Or do I look like I'm different? I don't know. You tell me. I don't know how I look or appear to other people. I know how I look to me. But I don't think I come across like I look religious or anything. I don't think I come across where I look like I'm different, or I may carry myself different, or, and that don't mean I judge people, because I've been in every circle, and for the most part I've been around or sat around people who may live a completely different life from me, and that's cool to a certain extent. As long as they heart, the way they carry people, treat people, is still good, you know, and they don't plan on being in certain lifestyles forever. But the way I am is like very mature. I've always wanted to be a mother. I've always wanted to be a wife. I've always wanted to be a family person who takes the kids out and go places for children or take care of my family. Yes, I want to still enjoy my life and be young and have fun. But my idea of being young and having fun is like going to a concert. I've always enjoyed concerts. I've always enjoyed shows. So like, I want to go see different shows in person, go travel, like go to different vacations. Yes, I'll have fun. Like, I love to do like things on beaches, water, jet skis, like speeding boats or anything, paddle boats. I've done all of that, like skating. I don't mind doing that. I don't mind bowling, like activities, right? I don't mind walking, hiking, going places, adventuring out, those type of things. But like clubbing, partying, drinking alcohol, passed out, like smoking hookah every weekend or every other Tuesday, I don't know when people go smoke hookah, going to happy hour, like I'm just not that girl. Like, and I'm all, and that's what always kept me separated. And it's a good thing to a certain extent, because, you know, I don't do too much. But then it's a bad thing, because sometimes I'm like the oddball out. I can't fit in. Like, if I go to a brunch or a bar right now, I'm not gonna be sitting there dancing, twerking like out loud. And there's nothing wrong with that. I'm not saying it in a negative way for the people that do it when it's the time. But it's like, I don't have that energy. That's not who I am. I've never carried myself like that. And then I've been this person for so long that it's hard for me to even come out of my shell. Like, even when I kind of sometimes may feel like, oh, maybe I want to do that a little bit, it's like, it's not really there, because I've just been this way. So I say that to say, you know, people think that everybody's the same, everybody carries themselves the same, but me, I don't. Always been different. Police was right there. Sorry, y'all. But I carry myself different, always been different, the way I act. If you've always been different, just comment below. Help me to not feel like I'm the only one. Because, like, even as a child, I know every girl had those little dolls where you could do their hair. I think I might have had one. I don't remember really having one. But I'm not that girl. And I say this all the time, like, I didn't play with Barbies, I did math problems. On God, I really did. Like, on my grandmother's wall at her house, my grandmother who lived in her house forever, you can see if the painting wasn't there, under that painting, there's a layer of me writing math problems on that pole. Going down the steps, you can see me writing my name on the wall. I was that kid, I wrote my name on the walls, clearly, just like every other kid. But just always been different, just always been extremely different, just always been unique, just always have been in my own lane, never been the same. And so because of that, I carry myself different to this day. At 28 years old, I'm getting, you know, I'm still young, but it's like, I don't seek to do the things that other people seek to. And so that's why it hurts me even more, devastates me even more, because I'm the type of person where I want a family. I want that family unit. I want a man who as a husband and a father, who I can take my child and we can take, you know, he'll be our child to some degree or extent, I guess. I don't know how I feel about that. But, and like go places and do things and enjoy ourselves and live a life of still having fun, still enjoying yourself, still being you, but you're not in the streets like that. You're not out here twerking. You're not out here smoking hookah every weekend. I smoke hookah before. Yes, I have. But I'm saying, like, that's just not my lifestyle. Like, I like to do activities, events, go places, hear people speak. And, like, and I'm not saying I'm at the opera. I'm not saying that's my life either. I'm not saying I'm, you know, golfing. Like, nothing's wrong with golfing. But I'm just saying, you know what category that is. You know, I don't really fit in those categories either. So, yeah, I'm extremely late to work again. This is why I'm not even trying to be funny. Hopefully, by the time I post these videos, I found a job closer to me in my proximity. Because this traveling all the way to this side to work, when my son's childcare is all the way on the other side where I used to live, and then I live like in the middle, is extremely, extremely a problem. It's becoming too much. Like, the gas going back and forth every day out here, plus the time that it takes to get there, get him on that side, and get him to this side. And I don't make enough for this. Like, this is a waste of time. So yeah, but pray for me. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. This is MoreShay with MoreShay, and as always, I'll be back.